Hello, this is Dr. Lonnie Wright, and I'm in my office at the College of Southern Nevada. How did I get here? I've been a associate vice president, a dean, twice chair of my Department of Hospitality Management. And how did I get here? I give all credit to being a student athlete. I got my undergraduate degree at UNLV, where I was a student athlete. I played basketball on a four-year scholarship. I graduated on time as a student athlete. I got my baccalaureate in hospitality management. And I went on and got my master's in post-secondary secondary ed. How did I get my master's? I got my master's through a program called the UNLV Basketball Alumni Association. I founded that program by myself in 1977. That program was founded because at that time, student athletes only got 4 years to graduate. And I did put the emphasis on student instead of athlete. Although, yes, I, like any other athlete, would like to go to that next level and try to play pro ball and make a lot of money. But I knew for sure that I didn't have my priorities mixed up. I wanted to indeed get my degree, which I did. So I started the Basketball Alumni Association because a lot of the guys that played ball with me, they didn't graduate. And all of them, not all of them, but a lot of them put all of their eggs in one basket. And that was the basket of playing pro basketball. I raised the awareness to some of my friends that played ball with me that, hey, listen, we're gonna start this organization and we're gonna raise money for you to come back and go to school. Because those that didn't make it to the pros, a lot of them ended up in their prospective ghettos, never to be heard from again until we called them and said, hey, how would you like a second chance? How would you like to have more years to get that degree that was a golden opportunity that you didn't take advantage of? And it was overwhelming. And I said, well, one thing that you're gonna have to do is you're gonna have to participate in our fundraising to get this money for you to go back to school. And our biggest fundraiser was the UNLV Basketball Alumni Association's alumni game, a game that we played against the best, UCLA twice, North Carolina twice. And when I mentioned those two great schools, their alumni were nothing but NBA ball players. We had Magic Johnson, we had Michael Jordan, Sleepy Floyd, and Patrick Ewing, on and on and on. In this film, you'll see all of the great schools that we've played, all of the illustrious ball players that played and helped us raise money to send our athletes back to school. We also raised the awareness that you needed that degree to have longevity, to have a better quality of life. And so a lot of our guys came back. They played in the alumni games. We raised a lot of money. Not only did we start a baccalaureate program, but we started a master's program. And that's how I got my master's, from a program from an organization that I started. So I was pretty lucky. I hear about people having all of these debts in college. I was really blessed to get my baccalaureate and my master's from a program I started. I got my doctorate from being a tenured professor in the university and college system. So I've been very blessed to, as far as my education is concerned. I want this program to continue. This tradition has been around for many, many years at UNLV, and we haven't really celebrated something that we think it may have had some influence on the NCAA in adding that fifth year to student athletes, which was really needed. And there were other alumni like Fresno. We played them and we went away to play them, and they wanted to start an organization to send their athletes back to school. Well, with the baccalaureate program and the master's program, we also reached out to all of the sports. We were doing so well that we said that football players, not only basketball players, men and women, all sports could go back to school. I am making an appeal to you to help us to raise enough money to put a quality documentary together so we can celebrate and to let everyone know really how innovative UNLV Basketball Alumni Association was and how we put emphasis on student athletes going back to school to get not only their baccalaureates but their masters and revitalizing our efforts with our student athletes as far as academics is concerned. Thank you.
The UNLV Basketball Alumni Association was founded in 1977 to help former student athletes with their educational needs. Because of practice, travel, and physical conditioning requirements, student athletes have tremendous burdens not shared by other students. The UBAA was formed by athletes who understood these problems. The main thrust of the UNLV Basketball Alumni Association is to fund post-athletic educational endeavors of former UNLV athletes. Scholarships from the UBAA Education Fund have allowed numerous athletes to continue their education and earn their degrees. The UNLV Basketball Alumni Association is proud to be the first of its kind in the nation. And following its inception, several other organizations around the country have taken the association's lead.
UNLV Alumni Association is very, very important because it helps people. And anytime you deal with any association that helps people, it's very, very important. And that's why I feel strongly about the association. And I also want to help out the association because they do a fantastic job. They helped a lot of people graduate. They help a lot of young people. And so they're committed to help people. And they just don't talk about it. They go out and do it. And that's the importance.
The UNLV Basketball Alumni Association has many different fundraising activities. Among them are the Summer Alumni Games, featuring former Rebel stars against NBA greats, such as Michael Jordan, Patrick Ewing, and Magic Johnson.
On August 28th, the Michigan State Spartans will come to Las Vegas and kill the running Rebels.
What a challenge. The NBA's most valuable player, Magic Johnson, will lead Michigan State against the best from UNLV. It's August 28th at the Thomas & Mack Center, co-sponsored by KLAV Radio and TV5. The Rebels, led by NBA stars Sid Green, Reggie Theus, and Armon Gilliam, will face their biggest test in Scott Skiles, 7-footer Kevin Willis, and the Magic Man.
We're coming to Vegas to get ya.
You know, it should be a good game tomorrow night. A lot of fun out there. You know, you'll probably see more behind-the-back passes tomorrow night than you would see in a couple of NBA games. The overnight...
By the way, the game is tomorrow at 8 o'clock.
Yeah, I think I heard that.
I don't know if you heard that.
Yeah. Tonight's the night when the UNLV alumni basketball team takes on the Michigan State alumni squad, which is led by Irvin Magic Johnson and Scott Skiles.
All right, tip-off is 8:05 tonight. The Thomas might get there early for the fireworks show. It's supposed to be spectacular. The
Magic show will begin 8 o'clock tonight.
Sure?
Thomas & Mack Center, I'm pretty sure, be there.
Well, the big Rebel alumni game is tonight, and Dave Dietrich is live at Caesars Palace now.
It seems to me that we beat UCLA twice, we beat North Carolina twice, we beat Georgetown once, so I don't, you know, Magic is one of the great players of all time, but I don't know that it's going to happen over here tonight.
I said we were going to kill them. They played the rest, but they haven't played the best, and the best is Michigan State. I'm looking right in the camera to all you people and saying that, yes, Michigan State the best. You will see the Running Rebels get ran out of Thomas Mack Arena tonight. Be there, 8 o'clock.
Over 16,000 fans. That's the best attendance ever for an alumni game. And they saw their money's worth tonight.
I showed up.
Standing room only, and it was one of the best games I have ever seen.
Sure it was.
Tremendous game. Michael Jordan in North Carolina couldn't do it. Patrick Ewing and the Hoyas fell short, as did the alumni basketball teams of UCLA, Notre Dame, and BYU. Tonight, it was Magic Johnson and Michigan State's turn to play the UNLV Running Rebel alumni basketball team. And lo and behold, Johnson and company won.
Oh,
think that UNLV athletics is very important for the image of the community. We get more national recognition from our basketball program and in the future our football program than we've ever gotten before from any other single part of the community. And so it's important that we project a positive image. The UNLV Alumni Basketball Association is a significant stride in that direction, having national media coverage of their efforts to educate the athletes after they've completed their athletic career. The community can support it in the fashion that they have here tonight by giving them financial support and giving them positive feedback as to our belief that this is a very good thing, not only for the players, but for the university and the whole community.
In the summers of 1988 and 1989, Caesar's Palace sponsored the UNLV alumni on tours of the Far East. Running Rebel greats were goodwill ambassadors, playing to sold-out crowds across the Orient.
We have basketballs, a lot of basketballs.
Basketball?
Yeah.
Four.
Yeah, pause. Do you have basketballs when we go in practice?
Don't you bring?
We brought a couple, but do you have any more?
Any more
basketballs?
Basketball.
Yeah.
You need.
And we are very glad to bring our team here today to Taiwan to have a goodwill match with our good friends in Taiwan. And this team is our best team in in USA.
Yeah. No, we have two. Two. Only have two. We only yeah. have two.
Only have two.
Yes.
Yeah. But and tomorrow
we need four more. Four more. Please.
Programs that have been designed, such as this organization's, working with Lonnie Wright and others, I think are very solid contributions. So I would think that progress is made, and we need to publicize what we're doing in this area. The public doesn't read something unless it's a banner story, so you need to repeat the message over and over again for the full impact. But I think some important steps have been taken, and I applaud the progress that's been made.
To help in their fundraising endeavors, the association now produces their own music videos.
Talk you.
I think this program is particularly exciting because it's targeted at young men who have such a tremendous burden and demand made on their schedules during the year that very often it's difficult for them to carry a full course load and do well. And they recognize that fact, and they make a commitment that when they have concluded their official 4 years at school, that they are going to go ahead and get their degree, even if it means returning to school in the summertime or continuing on for additional years until they achieve that goal. And you can't help but feel that that is a wonderful thing for them to do. If anything, it shows even more determination than a regular student who is willing to just devote 4 years to college and then get on with it. And I think it's a wonderful program, and that's why I'm here tonight. I love Jerry Tarkanian and the Rebels, but this is a particularly meaningful thing that they're doing.
After years of successfully providing scholarships and promoting alumni games, the association decided to expand its role in the Las Vegas area. The UBAA originated several youth-oriented programs, which were provided at no charge to the children of Las Vegas. In the fall of 1988, the association joined forces with Campbell Soup to create the Super Kids Shootout. In 1984, the association began publishing the Rebel Roundball Report. Since its inception, the newspaper circulation has skyrocketed. The association and Southland Corporation have joined to make the paper available, free of charge, to all 150 area 7-Eleven stores. The Roundball Report offers you inside information, top 20 updates, Big West stats, and everything else the UNLV fan wants to know. Following the success of the Super Kids Shootout, the UBAA and Campbell Soup collaborated once again to create the Campbell Super Camps. These basketball camps were staffed by former running Rebels who emphasized the importance of saying no to drugs and gangs.
One-time Rebel defensive whiz Gary Graham, along with other former running Rebels Mark Wade, Anthony Todd, and Lonnie Wright, they've all been part of this spring's Basketball Alumni Association's Campbell's Super Camps for Kids. The objectives have been twofold. First, give the kids some solid coaching in the fundamentals of basketball. And second, by their own examples and words, give the youngsters clear alternatives to gangs and drugs.
Really? Told you, ma'am? Yeah? Okay, anybody else?
That's a strong person right there. He was able to tell his friends he couldn't hang around because he didn't want to do what they were doing.
How many of the rest of you guys in here are strong enough to do that?
Did we get a chance to educate the kids on certain things other than just sports? I mean, because there's some things that I wish I could have learned growing up that now I look back on life probably would have helped me growing up.
How many of you guys hear about the gangs and all this going on around town, huh? What's some of the names of the gangs around town?
I learned that being famous is not the only thing in life, and that not to get involved with gangs and taking drugs.
What about the lesson after basketball? What do they talk to you about?
About not taking drugs and not being in gangs.
Does it make a lot of sense to you?
Mm-hmm.
Steven Jackson, Channel 13 Sports.
These have been a few of the programs that, with your support, the UNLV Basketball Alumni Association has already accomplished. We look forward to the years ahead where, with your continued support, the association can sponsor programs that will benefit the university and the people of Las Vegas.